of God and the presence of these witnesses to join Scott and Donna in holy matrimony, which is an honorable estate instituted by God. It is therefore not to be entered into unadvisedly but reverently, discreetly, and in the love of God, into this holy estate Scott and Donna come now to be joined. You've been called to marriage with each other, and God has blessed you in this calling. Together, all of us form a circle of prayer and blessing here in this wonderful and special corner of the world, where we are each invited to be and to become together. Donna and Scott have invited all of us to be their beloved community for this day. And here we hear the voice of God in the youngest and eldest. So please join us now in prayer. Creator Christ and Comforter, be with us and bless this day, bless this couple, bless this gathering. Be with us every step of the way wherever our paths may take us. Remind us to call upon you as you taught us to pray, saying together, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but for evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever. Amen. There are different variations, and they all go through the ears of God, who all said exactly the right words, right? So now it is my pleasure to invite Isabella to come forward with the first greeting that Donna and Scott have chosen. It's also a reminder that your light comes from the holy light of God, And the first thing that I'm going to say is not going to surprise you. When she also says that while they were friends as a copy, she also thought of him as a mentor, but there was something else brewing besides coffee and friendship. She noticed how cute he was. She loved his big blue eyes and how handsome he looked in his leather jacket, but she kept it to herself because she thought, he's a mentor and I better not actually say anything. Until Scott invited her up to watch him go flying in a three-seater biplane with Elizabeth. Does that sound right? And after that, there was a dinner, and then I asked him to tell me stories about like what makes up their relationship, and he said, oh, the next big thing was Canopy Lake Park. Does everybody remember Canopy Lake Park? That's a big family story, right? But it wasn't about water slides and lazy rivers. It was about two families that are dearly beloved by their parents, meeting and connecting. And that has been the whole story this whole time. And so I'm going to say a few things that they love about each other. But their story, when I asked them for their story, was all about you guys. It was about the family being together. Donald loves about Scott that he's smart, sweet, kind, and thoughtful. Aside from the fact that he doesn't easily give up the wheel and doesn't like mama's driving, he's the perfect mate. She says he's handsome, and she loves the way that he drives. Scott says that the room lights up when Donna smiles, and she's beautiful. Donna loves that Scott cares about details, like the flower press that he made for the flower that Evan gave him from National Honor Society. Or when he's working on the car, the deputy explains every step of what he's doing, but it's in a way of sort of including people and teaching people. And she even loves the fact that he vacuums out both of their cars when he's taking care of things. They say that together, they help each other out and they pick each other up. That they have complementary styles, they mesh well, and they share tasks together, but more importantly, they share their everyday life together, and they care about each other. So it really doesn't matter what they're doing together, right? Shopping or watching their favorite flicks on TV or shows during winter, or going to a new beach to watch the sunset, or going to amusement parks. Their story isn't about big milestones or monuments. It's about little daily quotidian moments and how those add up and create the foundation for a love that is enduring and abiding and is informed by holiness and shows us what holiness looks like in everyday life when it flows through the hearts of people that are generous with each other and with each other's children and with the world. Are you here to make a promise? Alright. We're going to exchange vows now. This is where I'm going to say one line at a time, and you're going to repeat it after I say it, but you're going to look at each other, okay? And I'm going to start with you again. So you're going to say to Donna, Donna, I will espouse you with integrity and justice. I will espouse you with tenderness, love and support. which unites these two parts through love. Would you all please put your hands cupped up like this so that you may help bless the rings together? And we are in a moment of prayer as we do this blessing. Gracious God, bless these symbols of covenant promise, that they may remind Donna and Scott of your encircling love and unending faithfulness, that in their life together they may know joy and peace in one another. Amen. Announce with joy that you are from this time on husband and wife. and I introduce to you both, to all of you, Mr. and Mrs. Scott and Donna.